them alphabetically, I'll have to do the first one. So the work we tried to showcase from UCL was on this work across the length scales in liquid-liquid flows. And we've included some posters from the large-scale flows we have been working on, the microchannel flows, and the medium-scale flows or coalescence experiments. In the large-scale flow, as we mainly had the posters and the videos, we had a setup for these small channel flows where we actually demonstrated the experiments we carried in collaboration with Birmingham. So we had some nice drop size generation. A recap from what basically we also said yesterday. These are the facilities we are working on large scale flows at UCL and some different flow patterns we managed to observe with our PAD systems. And I have to follow the slide pace. And these are also some visual observations and the results we get when we use our bluff bodies, the wave generation, and here is the PAD studies that show us the vortices that form behind the bluff bodies. Small channel flows, we demonstrate actually the droplet generation, and these are the PAV results we get when we use our two-color PAV system. Again, some results in the posters outside, both from the T-junction, like this one here, or the cross-flow configuration we have with Birmingham. Go back to the previous one. And these are also, what I want to mention here is the fact that we've been using non-Newtonian fluids as well in these studies. And here is what happens at the inlet when a non-Newtonian fluid breaks to form plugs. This is the collaboration with Birmingham and with Imperial College, because we have the experiment, the detailed velocity field measurements, and very nice simulations with Code Blue and Lies. And these are actually, I should say here, Nina has already produced a paper on this one, and we are working on the second one. And the coalescence results here, the different setups we use for the 3D and the 2D configuration, and some videos and flow field measurements of the droplets coalescing with an interface. Actually, these studies here, these studies here are with non-Newtonian fluids, and these are with surfactants. And some more videos now of the non-Newtonian fluid coalescence and the velocity fields that we have observed developing. And as I said yesterday, and also wanted to make this link to where all these fundamental experiments and knowledge lead, is in our case to applications such as process intensification, because we use a lot of these microchannel flows to carry out intensified extractions, liquid-liquid extractions. And we work in both small scales, microchannels like this one here, and we get very good mass transfer coefficients, but also in intensified systems of a bit larger scale, like impinging jets. A few future plans, and these are also coming from the discussions we had with our industrial partners and suggestions that were put forward yesterday. In large scale flows, we want to improve our predictive capabilities of the different flow pattern transitions, and to link these transitions to the small scale building blocks, because we're scientists and we're trying to understand why things happen. These building blocks are the breakage and coalescence phenomena in our cases. And we also look at small channel flows for their applications in a number of process industries, for the production of emulsions, for example, but also for process intensification. And I think I'll finish here. I'll stop it.